Alright, so we'll see how terrible this is. I don't think it's going to be as bad as the other Seymour fights, but I don't know. I didn't think those were going to be so hard. Well, I kind of did, but this one we're kind of more prepared for, because we have Zombie Ward, we have Death Proof, we have Mighty Guard, we have Evade Encounter, we have all sorts of stuff. Thank you. Alright, so let me actually switch to Evade Encounter right now. I was considering using Magic Counter, but I'm not really even sure, like, he has that. Oh shit, I actually got zombied. So, Mighty Guard comes with Protect and, Shell. Both of them, so. So, yes.
You have anchored Kimahri. The spirits of the Ronso will guide Kimahri's spear.
Ooh, dispel. Interesting. This could be bad. Okay, I survived. Oh, and I do have auto potion on. Oh, I forgot to show you my my equipment. I've got a Shaman Armlet, which has Silence Proof, Death Proof, Zombie Ward, and Auto Potion. And I also have, well, the usual. But yeah, I think that's the setup I'll go with, because, and I'll basically just try and run through all my potions before I fight Unaleska, so that I can just heal with high potions the whole time. But for now, let's heal with an with a X potion. So it's cool that Kimahri's strength got upgraded for this battle. Let's see. I don't really. So there's Mortiorcus again. And I think that works the same way. Like, if I damage that enough, like, it'll absorb from Seymour. I don't really need to do that at the moment. But let me actually just defend here, so I don't give him two turns in a row. And let's do that again. Or actually, let's use a high potion this time. Okay, so I guess he has just the planned attack of Dispel. Ooh, that would not be good. That would give him a lot of turns in a row. Let's just use, I think he's gonna use Lance of Atrophy and then, oh yeah, I don't wanna give him two attacks in a row. Oh, Cross Cleave, okay. I could have attacked once. Or no, then he would probably have killed with Lance of Atrophy or whatever the fuck, however the fuck you pronounce that word. I'm still able to get some damage on him by counterattacking. Ooh, and then he might have even, ooh, actually, that would have been really bad if I gotten zombied there. Because I would have been fucking dead. Okay, so this might be just a race against the clock here. Like, waiting. Like, if that happens, we're fucking dead, dude. Yeah, I think Mighty Guard, like, doesn't last that long because of his dispel. Why don't we use a high potion? That sounds good. Okay, we didn't get zombied, that's good. Okay, now we have a turn after his turn, so let's use an overdrive to deal some massive damage. Ooh, and it looks like we've got his health down enough where he's starting to use some defensive magic. Let's just defend this turn. I think that potion is actually just going to give me just enough health to survive this. Or no, it's not. I think I'm dead, actually. Oh, shit, I didn't realize that... Oh, fuck, that was actually a mistake then. Okay, alright. Fuck it then. Okay, alright, okay. I'm going to have to be more careful about this. In that case, I don't really think... that's the right way to go about this. Huh. Alright, let me try another setup and then I'll come back. Alright, so this time, I decided that in addition to evade and counter, I'm gonna give myself auto haste, which I got from capturing all the... where is it? It's at the very bottom, actually. Which I got from capturing everyone in the Thunder Plains, and I also I put it on Tetra Armlet, which I got from the shop at the base of Mount Gagazette, with HP plus 10% and defense plus 10%. I also, like, I just didn't know what to do for the last slot, because, I don't know, I feel like I might customize this a little bit more later, and I don't want to just put, like, Zombie Ward on it, because that's, like, specific to this and only this battle. So I just left it empty. And I think that should be enough, honestly. Because I have plenty of holy waters. Honestly, I think this is going to be like a little bit too easy, maybe. But we'll see. You have angered Kimahri-Only. I mean, Mighty Guard is kind of pointless. Because it's just going to get dispelled immediately. So why don't we just use a Thrust Kick to deal 7,000 damage, which happens to be, like, fucking a tenth of his health. I'm considering killing Riku so I can get more... she'll die eventually, though. Like, I don't need to worry about her. Oh, damn, critical! Oh my god, he's already using Protect after 3 hits! Yeah, she's dead. Okay, so he's gonna use full life next, right? So I don't have anything to worry about next turn. I mean, I could start hitting, like, Mortibody or whatever, but... like, I'm already dealing, like, nearly 2,000 damage just with Protect alone, and... my Thrust Kick ignores defense, so... I don't feel an immense need to, attack the Mortibody over just Seymour. Please have a turn. Please give me a turn. What the fuck? Oh, this is gonna be so easy, he said. Oh, this is just gonna be the easiest thing in the world, huh? Oh yeah, this is just gonna be a walk in the park, huh? A breeze, a step, a daytime romp through the woods. This is gonna be... okay, what the fuck was that shit? How did he get 3 turns in a row? Well, I mean, I expected him to get 2 in a row because of, like... I don't really understand how this boss works, is one problem. Is it like that Seymour casts, like, Lance of Atrophy, and then it's the Mortibody who does full life? Is that how it works? So was it Mortibody who used Cross Cleave, and then Seymour used Lance of Atrophy, and then Mortibody used full life? Is that how it worked? That has to be how it worked, right? I guess. Like, I don't think I, like, got slowed or anything, did I? Okay, so I'm thinking... hold on. Did I equip? Forgot to equip that. That might be costly. But I think, what is it? What the hell? Oh, is this, oh my god, is this really fucking happening right now? Is that really what's happening? Wow. That was quite the attempt right there. Alright. Never mind. Well, I was gonna say, like, I think that cross cleave might have a bit of delay. Like, it might cause delay. But I don't know anymore. I don't know anything. I'm gonna have to be. I guess I just have to be really careful not to let Seymour have a turn and then for Mortibody to have a turn, because I think that that's what the Lands of Atrophy full life combo is. Alright, so this time I actually do have the correct armor on, so I don't need to waste a turn at the beginning.
You have angered this.
Alright, so every time that there's one of those situations going on, I need to, like, assume the worst that it's going to be. Maybe I should switch between Zombie Ward and Auto Haste. Maybe that should be my move. But yeah, assume that it's going to be this, exactly this. Lance of Atrophy followed by Full Life. Oh, max damage! My overdrive must have went critical. I don't think it will be. It can't be Lance of Atrophy again, can it? I don't think it can. Huh, so. Okay, so right there, Seymour didn't take a turn. Because he already took a turn. Alright, interesting. Okay, so this one is not going to be... not going to include full life, so I can attack. This one might. So I need to switch to defending armlet. So I can potentially survive it. And then just switch armlets again for no reason. Well... oh, actually, I should have this on anyway. Where is it? Fucking, I went right by it. Okay, I think cross cleave might have delay. That's what I was getting at. Last attempt. Yes, it definitely does. It definitely does. Cross cleave definitely has delay. I need to, like, take that into account. Okay, let's see. So, I want to... yeah, this takes priority over everything else, healing up. Because I can't take another of those. Okay, and luckily luckily I got poisoned while I still had a turn to heal. So I believe this battle will take a certain element of luck, but I don't think it's going to be anything near the level of anima luck. I think this is going to actually be easier than the previous two Seymour fights. Like, the previous one was easier than the first one, and the first one was harder than the second one. Whatever. Fuck me. Let's see. So let us put on the one at the very bottom, because I was too lazy to bring it up to the top, and now it's costing me time, precious time! Alright, it was dispel. Fucking useless. You can't dispel auto-haste! Doesn't work that way. Okay, so let's use this opportunity to do a little thrust kick, which goes through protect, and then we will go ahead and switch to defending. So just gotta be on my toes here is really, like, if I'm smart about it, I don't think he can kill me with this. This isn't gonna kill me, never mind, fuck it. Oh my god. I just was talking about how he couldn't kill me through fucking damage alone. That's what I was getting at there, but he did. He fucking did. He did exactly what he said. What should I have done? Should I fucking, I shouldn't have gotten greedy and went for the overdrive. I guess what I should have done is I should have, like, switched to auto-haste immediately. Or no, healed and then switched to zombie ward. Bleg. So this time, like, I really, really don't want to just waste this last spot here with zombie ward. I can only get one auto-haste, right? So I don't want to just, like, put it on an armor that I'm only going to use for this battle. So I definitely want to, like, switch between these two if I can. And by the way, I decided to put Zombie Ward on a Blessed Armlet, which will allow me to have HP plus 10, so I don't actually lose any HP between these two when I switch between these two armlets. But anyway, let's use our first turn to talk. And our second turn to, yeah, do that. I'm so used to escaping. So, I really don't know, like, his attack pattern, if there is one. All I'm really doing is just, like, watching out for that type of turn right there, where he has, they both have a turn in a row. Because that's what I really need to, that's what's really going to be deadly. Is if, like, it goes Lance of Atrophy, then full life. Everything else I think I can prepare for. As long as I don't fucking get greedy like last time and not heal. My problem last time is that I should have only attacked when I was, like, 100% guaranteed to not be hit by a bunch of shit. Like, when I had full health and everything. Alright, so this time he does have two turns in a row with that, so I'm gonna switch to Zombie Ward. And, it was unnecessary in the end, but he may actually still do exactly that. Yeah, he will. I may be able to get a turn in if I switch to auto haste right now, but I don't want to risk it. I'd rather just make sure that I have enough health here. This is definitely a situation where I want to break out an X potion. Or three. That was kind of uncoordinated there. It was like full life and then Lance of Atrophy. Okay, cool. Let's do this, and then do this. And now let's not be stupid, let's actually just heal. And attack. And he has two turns in a row, so let's switch to Zombie Ward. Oh, and I know what's gonna happen here. He's gonna use this, then with the delay, it's gonna let him use Lance of Atrophy, and then full life. Oh fuck, I think I'm dead. Yeah, I'm dead. Oh shit, dude. What do I do there? I don't know, what can I do? I don't think he was even close to dead yet. Maybe I do have to fucking waste my last empty slot on Zombie Ward. I don't know how much more that would help, though. Alright, so I was thinking about, like, if I should just, like, keep trying until I get, like, perfect luck, or if I should just, like, get auto-haste and zombie ward on at the same time and just try and, like, luck it that way, or try and get a turn in between his attacks. No, no. But I decided we're doing none of that. We've got... Oh, we don't have it on right now. Let's switch to auto-med. I grinded for, like, 10 hours at Blitzball just getting remedies, and I think this will make this battle significantly easier. I'm hoping so, at least. Because whenever I get hit with Lance of Atrophy now, Kimahri will instantly heal it. So I won't have, like, an instant death warrant with full life anymore, I don't think. I don't want to equip auto haste, like, if I can't get this set up to work. I think that I will be able to get it to work if I include auto haste on my current armor with auto med. So I think I should be able to do this. Yeah, let's see it in action. There you go. Yeah, and I would have been dead right there if I hadn't done that. If I didn't have automat. So there it is. Or no, 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 no. I should learn from my mistakes. We must heal to full HP every time we get hit. He'll die eventually from counterattacks. Ooh, this could actually be pretty bad. Damn, I'm just getting nothing but critical hits right now. Wait, why didn't Kimahri heal it? Oh, okay, I see. Oh, that was like his counterattack, I see. It was protect. Because he got below a certain amount of HP. Please have a turn. Okay, this doesn't matter. Just get a turn right now. Kimahri, please. Okay, thank you. Alright, definitely warrants an X potion. I don't think that, like, three turns in a row should be enough to kill me with auto-med. So let's just keep attacking. What I do have to watch out for, though, is he can do an attack that apparently is pretty, like, lethal to anyone at any point. So I need to be sure to watch out for that. It, like, takes three turns for him to charge it up. I forget the name. But I definitely do need to watch out for that and prepare with Mighty Guard before he uses that. A Mega Potion should be enough. Yeah. Let's see, worst case scenario, he uses Cross Creep twice. I don't think he's gonna do that though, but if he does, I'm dead, so. So I don't, like, I know that, like, I've gotten a good number of hits off on him, but I don't really know, like, how much I have left to go. So I'm gonna kind of be protective here. Make sure I don't get killed. Because I want to have a full overdrive by the time he enters his final phase. Where he starts using that death attack I was talking about. Let's see. Yeah, we cure up before every attack. I'm probably being too cautious at this point. I probably could be more, like, aggressive, but I'm gonna be a little aggressive. I'm not attacking the mortar body because fuck that. Like, I can already deal, like, the amount of time, like, it would take me 2 attacks to deal 4,000 points of damage to him. And I'm already, and in that time, I could have just dealt, like, 3,500 damage to him. So, okay, I think this might be the final phase. Yeah. Oh shit, flare! Oh god, oh dear. Fuck. Okay. I should have been more cautious. Wow, the one turn I take a risk, I get just pwned. Amazing. I'm being really careful. I should, like, I don't know, I don't feel like I need to take, like, keep track of his health too much, but I really should be, because then I'll know, like, when to be careful. But eh. Screw it. I don't wanna. Okay. That was what I was preparing for. Okay, so I want to wait as long as possible. Like, he takes 3 turns to charge up his super attack. I want to wait as long as possible before I cast Mighty Guard. So he doesn't dispel it. Whoa, damn. I can't take 2 of those. Oh, damn. Can I survive this? Oh my god, just barely. Holy shit. Wow, I wasn't expecting to be able to survive that at all. I thought I was dead for sure. Wow. So good thing I just put this on a plus 10% defense thing. But the problem here is, how the hell am I gonna get an attack in? I'm just healing. So I don't actually need Mighty Guard then. I'll just do this. Man, Kimahri's so strong. You can just take fucking Seymour's strongest attack to the face and still live to tell the tale. Okay, so he doesn't seem to be using any physical attacks or, what was the other one? He doesn't seem to be using Lance of Atrophy, basically, so I think I can afford to turn off Automed and switch to SOS Haste. And I guess I'll also stick on... Ooh, SOS Overdrive, I like that. Yeah, let's do that. Oh, so now I can survive 2 flares, it looks like. In that case, why don't we just... Well, no. He might use Total Annihilation again. Yeah, Explosion. It's not the most optimal time to use it, I guess, but... Meh. I set that up before. Wait. Shit. Oh god. Oh fuck. Oh dear. Oh no. Oh, thank god. Okay. I thought I was dead. Alright. I can just use Mega Potion. I thought I was so dead, dude. When I saw that, like, I was like, oh shit, he has two turns in a row. He's gonna do it. But he didn't. Oh, but now I'm dead! I want to know how close I was. I was probably like right there. Okay. So. Here's, I think I've got this time. Because I customized Kane's Lance here with Magic Counter, which I believe will give me just enough time to do him in if I go all out. So let me go ahead and switch to SOS Haste. Somewhere. There it is. It's at the very top. Oh yeah, I put it there. What the hell? I probably scrolled right by it. And this too. This will allow it. There's nothing for us to counter in this phase in terms of physical attacks. So instead, I'm gonna counter magic attacks because he does flare. And that should give me the edge, I think. That I need to do this before he just annihilates me. Basically. No, I got cured. I guess I didn't really. There should be Seymour watches and waits right now, right? So I can afford an attack. And I already damaged Mordek. Oh, damn it. It didn't actually kill the Morta body. Whatever. Oh, god damn it, dude. What did I do there? I attacked. So I can't attack? Or what if I use Mighty Guard instead? He didn't seem to be dispelling at all. Yeah, maybe I should just use Mighty Guard for Shell. Okay, I'm kind of unprepared for this, because I didn't expect to get to this final stage so early, so I don't have my overdrive filled. I guess because I use my overdrive, I don't have it filled. That would make sense. So I guess priority number one should be to heal. Okay, if I can survive this attack, in other words, if Seymour doesn't just go into Flare on his next turn after this, I can cast Mighty Guard. Okay, good. So let's start out by healing. No. Yeah, I have to heal. Right now is not the time to use Mighty Guard. Now is. So I should be able to take less damage from both attacks and hopefully survive them both. If my hunch is correct. Oh, unless, like, Total Annihilation just goes through both Shell and Protect, which it doesn't look like it did. Because my damage is certainly being halved right now. Excellent. I hate that. Oh, I actually... I did, like, 2,000-something previously, and that only did, like, 19-something, so I thought I just barely didn't get Mort Absorption, but... it looks like I just barely did. And I can survive a flare. Pretty sure. Two flares, probably. Do I still have Protect and Shell on? Did it not wear off yet? That's my current question. Shell protects. Okay. So in that case, I can use this overdrive for damage. I think I'm gonna waste a turn just to scan him. Because I want to make sure that I overkill him. Oh! Forgot about that. Immunity is threatened. I see. Okay, so that's not gonna work. I guess I just have to use Scout. Or Sensor. Oh, he still has quite a way to go. Okay. So 13,429. Let me actually just keep track of that from here. I should have been keeping track of it from the beginning, probably. But I'll just keep track of it from here. And I still have Shell and Protect? Yes? Okay. I don't know if this even wears off, but I gotta keep checking. Because if I fail to do it one time, it's GG. If I play my cards right, I believe I can get Ultima after this battle, so that's why I want to overkill him to make sure he drops two level 4 keysers. Actually, I might only need one, but I want both of them. Because why not, right? Yeah, I can afford to attack. So he has 8,000 health, roughly, right now. Do I still have Shell and Protect? I do. Let's just heal. So I'm gonna do two more attacks on him, just to be safe. before I break out my overdrive. Oh, he has, yeah, 6,400 health right now, so, yeah, an overdrive should definitely kill him. A thrust kick. And, I mean, if it doesn't, I can just, oh, hey, I'm gonna magic counter this anyway, so. GG, Seymour, I believe. Should be. Yeah! Alright, that was actually really fun. I enjoyed that battle. It took a lot of attempts, but, like, I just had to think about how to customize my equipment and all that stuff, and I overcame all the adversity and stuff like that. That was really enjoyable for me. That's probably one of the highlights of this challenge so far, is the fact that I was able to figure out a way without just wasting my auto-haste to beat Seymour Flux.
And stay up there!
I'm really happy about that. Really happy. So yeah, I'll probably... Well, we still got a little bit of Mount Gagaset to go. So. Yeah, two level keys for, level 4 key spheres, so we should have both Ultima and the remaining two level 4 key spheres now. After that. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I didn't actually need two key spheres to get Ultima, but... Hey, I got them, so... Alright, so this is probably, like, the very earliest I could... conceivably get Ultima, and I might actually need it for Sanctuary Keeper. Sanctuary Keeper is, like, gonna be the huge, like, I actually looked up, like a topic on Game Facts where people were talking about, oh, this could be possible, like, Kimahri own Sphere Grid could be possible, but how would you get past Sanctuary Keeper? So... I don't know. The Sanctuary Keeper is going to be quite the challenge. I'm going to use both of these on HP, because, you know, it's the best thing. But, that's a tale for another day, because first of all, we have to get through Gagazette Cave, but we now have Ultima. And I may have wanted to use one of those empty sphere grid things on magic, now that I think about it. But whatever. It's fine. I now have 5, well, that's with plus 20% defense, so it's like, I don't know, some lower amount of base damage, but, yeah, 27 magic is still not bad. I should be able to deal some decent damage with Ultima now. Aha! Here it is. I thought it was after this screen, but I guess it's right here. This is Saturn Crest, this is, something that we need to upgrade Kimahri's weapon, his ultimate weapon. So, I don't know if that'll come into play right now, but anyway, that looks to be the end of Mount Gagazette and Seymour Flux, so I will see you guys at Gagazette Cave.